On the Morning Groove this morning is a phenomenal Atlantan, a phenomenal woman, Black Girl Magic at its finest. You know her because you see her all the time doing for this city. You see her on the big screen. You see her walking the streets of the ATL. She is the daughter of the second lieutenant to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. She is the amazing Elisabeth Omilami. Welcome to the groove, baby.
Talk about a bloodline.
That is so sweet.
Oh, man, you know we absolutely love you for all you do, Miss O.
I love you, too. We go way back.
Yes, we do.
You know, we are still young at heart.
Yes, we are.
Young in mind and body, but we go way back.
And we look good, too.
Yeah. That's right.
Lord. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, man, we look good and we are doing good. You are at it again. 2020 celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. presented by Delta Airlines. Tell us what Hosea Helps will be doing this King holiday.
All day long. You know, I'll be coming back from D.C. where I will be speaking for my Zeta sisters.
Hey, oh, yeah. Right now.
Zetas!
Zetas out. And coming back and starting out that morning, giving out the first annual Lifetime Achievement Award from the Omilamis to John Evans.
Wow.
A great leader who's given his life to the community. And then we'll be kicking off that morning all day. We have a medical clinic with doctors from Morehouse School of Medicine. We have clothing distribution. We have hot showers. We have hair wash, beauty and beauticians and barbers. We need barbers,
yeah,
by the way.
We need barbers and beauticians. Yeah,
yeah. For that day. We'll be just having art full seven-course meal for people. We'll be just having Kids Corner with distribution of school supplies and book bags and home delivery of over 8,000 meals to people who are sick and shut in, seniors that can't get there.
Yeah.
And so we'll be on the stage if you want to come by and do some poetry or some spoken word.
Yeah.
You can do that. We'll be at the Georgia World Congress Center all day. This is the way we feel like Dr. King would have us celebrate.
Right.
And one of the things that my dad, who was actually the president of SCLC for a short period of time after Dr. King's death, thought the organization should go in the direction of service to people.
That was one of the things that motivated him to do what you're doing today.
Yes, yes, in 1970, because after Dr. King died, everybody split. One went this way, one went to the King Center, one went to politics, one went up to Chicago. I mean, he was the one who stuck here in Atlanta, who stuck to the mission and who saw a man eating out of a trash can on Auburn Avenue and said, you know, brother, in Atlanta, why should you be eating out the trash? And the guy said, man, I haven't eaten in 3 days.
Yeah.
So he went in the Yassim's Fish, which is still there on Auburn Avenue, bought him a sandwich, and the man ate through the wax paper and the paper bag to get to the food.
Yeah.
Immediately, Hosea Williams, who was a man of action, he very seldom sat on an idea, went across the street and started Jose Feed the Hungry, and that was 1970.
And so it begins.
That's
here we are, 40 years later, and you are still taking care of that mission to feed Atlanta's hungry and homeless with Hosea Helps.
Every day,
all
year long. And a lot of people don't know we're open every day. They think we're just holiday dinners, and they think we just feed people. But we have a women's life skill job program. We have a program for youth, which is food pantries in the schools and nutrition education and burning those calories and fighting youth diabetes. We have, of course, everyday emergency clothing and food distribution. We have Hosea on the move. If you live in a neighborhood where you're experiencing poverty, you can go to our website, number4hosea.org, register your neighborhood. We will bring to your neighborhood the 24-foot trucks and the case managers with hot spots and register you for food stamps. Mm-hmm. That's Jose on the Move. So we do a lot. We utilize about 9,000 volunteers a year. Mm. We are in the community every day, all year long, Jose is strong.
In the community of the community, yes. The 2020 celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is going down this Monday, 10 until 3, Georgia World Congress Center. You can donate. You can come on out and give some time. We like the, you know, where you give silently, too. Monetary donations would definitely help us out.
So I've been curious about this since you walked in the rooms, because you have all of the history, all the tidbits. There's one thing that we don't know.
Yeah.
I want you to share.
Well, I have a secret that is an exclusive just for Art and the Morning Crew.
I've been waiting on this.
I want to hear it.
I've been waiting on
this. What was the thing that Hosea Williams and Coretta Scott King literally fought about after Dr. King passed away, was killed, shall we say?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it was, should SCLC turn into the King Center? Or should it stay in the streets with the people?
Mm.
That was what they fought about. Because she was, you know, she felt that his legacy was most important.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that we need to do this to preserve his legacy.
Mm-hmm.
That we need to have his library. That we need to make his papers available. That we need to talk about, you know, because he didn't leave her much money. He left her like 10 grand.
Wow.
And, you know, he gave all his papers away to Boston University for free, didn't sell them. And the money that he got from the Pulitzer, he gave that to SCLC.
Yeah.
So she was here, a widow, with what, four children?
Four children. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Trying to figure out, how am I going to make it? The King Center was her way to go. But Jose Williams was like, Dr. King wants us in the street with the people doing direct action.
Mm. So who was it actually saying that maybe we should go the SCLC route versus, you know, Mrs. King saying, no, I have a bigger vision.
Yes.
What was that?
Very few people. Jose Williams was actually kind of blacklisted at SCLC because he fought for what he felt was Dr. King's mission, which was now becoming, getting ready to become intellectualized.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Lowry didn't particularly go his way. Andy really didn't go his way. Bernard Lafayette, Jesse left and went to Breadbasket. So he was kind of left there. And what he did was start Atlanta SCLC.
Right.
That was national SCLC.
Yeah.
And he utilized Atlanta SCLC to be a union man. I mean, he fought for union rights. He was boycotting and picketing companies about equal pay for women.
Mm-hmm.
He was working with the poor and the homeless even at that time. So he utilized that as his vehicle to do what he thought Dr. King would have him do. And what's interesting is that if Dr. King gave you an assignment, these men and women would stay on task until the assignment was done. Mm-hmm. There are people today like Tyrone Brooks, that are still at the Moores Mill Bridge where they murdered this family because Dr. King sent him there and the mission is not finished. And he's still on task.
Mm.
So that's the way they were. And so it wasn't this quick fix to everything.
Yeah.
And so that's what he did. Hosea Williams was the Martin Luther King after Martin Luther King died of the poor. And he didn't really care about color.
Right.
It was about class for him.
Right.
That's how he ended up stumping for Ronald Reagan. Mm-hmm. Because Ronald Reagan told him, if you change from a Democrat to a Republican and fight for me to be the president, I will make sure that Dr. King's birthday is a national holiday.
Mm.
So he did it.
It was a no-brainer for him.
Change from a Democrat to a Republican, was out there telling people to vote for Ronald Reagan.
Yeah.
People thought that he'd lost his mind. But Ronald Reagan kept his promise, and Martin Luther King's birthday became a national holiday. So he was a very complicated man. Mm. It was always about the mission, not about the party or the color.
And let me ask you this. I got to come through for Thanksgiving.
Yes.
And for anybody that's never been to when you go to the Congress mm-hmm. Center, the whole mm-hmm. building is dedicated to help.
Amazing.
From yeah. one end all the way yeah. to the other end, there were people who were there who would just pray with you. Mm-hmm. You might not have your finances good. So is there anything extra that we do need? Like, do we need some food prep people? It has so many sections. What things do we need now?
I think we need people out. Thank you for asking that question, because mm-hmm. I always forget to talk about what I need. Doctors and nurses. Mm. You know, people don't get to see a doctor. Right now, you can't even go to Grady because they had that pipe burst.
Yeah, right.
And they're saying, do not come this way unless mm-hmm. you're in trauma. Mm-hmm. So we need doctors. We need nurses. We need barbers and beauticians.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes the line for barbers and beauticians is longer than the line for food.
I've seen it. I've seen it. That's a long line.
Well, yes. If you look good, you feel good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And if you're trying to get back on your feet, the grooming, you've got to look the part.
That's right.
If you're trying to set up job interviews or something like that, you never know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And when you mentioned the prayer,
mm-hmm.
mental health is key for Jose Feed the Hungry this year. Because we found in our women's job skills program is that you cannot go interview for a job if you are depressed. If you're mm-hmm. coming out living in your car.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If you and your children are raggedy. Mm-hmm. You just don't, you can't sit before somebody and sell yourself.
Because it comes across in the interview, in conversation. They can hear it in your voice.
Your
they can feel it in your energy when you walk in the room. And Hosea Helps won't you put you in a position where you can win. Mm-hmm.
Yes. And so we do pray with people. We do have mental health counselors. We do your hair and your braids and your nails and your makeup. And when you come out of there, you know, it's an opportunity to feel, okay, I can go another day. Yeah. I can do this. And so in holding even people tell me, mm-hmm. don't hug those people. You don't know where they came from. You don't know what they might have. Mm-hmm. Your immune system is compromised. I'm like, oh, my heart's immune system will be compromised if I don't reach out and hug these people. Because truth is told, I need the hug just as much as they do.
Mm-hmm.
I need the human interaction just as much as they do. And so the volunteers who come get more out of the experience a lot of times than the so-called needy people mm-hmm. that are there, who are basically there saying, look, I got master's degrees sitting at those tables, Art.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I got people who went to college in overseas in London, etc., here homeless or here as working poor, because in America, across this country, the middle class is disappearing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's this great disparate between those the haves and what my dad called the have-nots.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have to come together as a community, churches, fraternities, sororities, community groups, and say, how do we help the working poor excel to be middle class so that they can then turn around and help others?
Mm-hmm. Now, y'all also doing on-site voter registration. It's an
Absolutely.
Election year going on. How important is that?
The census is critical, and voter registration is linked directly to the census. If we don't report our families in the census, our schools will lose money.
Yes.
Our trash will stop getting picked up.
Yes.
Our city services will deplete it. We've got to understand that we have to be counted in the census. And one of the ways that they count you in the census is when you register to vote.
Mm-hmm.
So we have voter registration on site at all of our events. And we have voter education as well. Because what we find out is, look, it doesn't matter if you vote for somebody that's African-American, if they don't think like an African-American.
Mm-hmm. Right, mm-hmm. right.
And I get in trouble mm-hmm. by saying that, because it's not about the color. It's about the content of your character.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Bottom line.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Hello. Once again, it's happening. 2020 celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. presented by Delta Airlines. It is Hosea Helps in your community. Monday, January 20th, Georgia World Congress Center, Thomas Murphy Ballroom. How many people are we expecting, Mrs. O?
We're expecting about 3,500 people.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing that breaks your heart is we see more whole families.
Mm.
And I want to tell anyone that's listening, there's no shame in this game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Come on down. If your children, we'd be distributing fresh fruits and vegetables, because nutrition is a big part mm-hmm. of our mission this year. not just our food boxes, which will be there as well. Don't be ashamed to come and get all, pack your car with everything. We're going to have collard greens and corn and green peas and oranges, apples, fresh fruits. My husband said he told them, go straight to that farmer's market first thing Friday morning, fill the truck up because, you know, collard greens is... just found out that's good for you.
Yeah, it is. Now you know. Now that you know, they can make it bad too, Miss O. But we gonna make the good greens.
Yes, yes. So come
you guys
out.
Are funny.
You don't have to be ashamed to ask for help.
Yeah.
Who, you know, who hasn't needed help before? Mm-hmm. So I think that events like this, this is the largest gathering of volunteers and people who are being served in this region. And we do these events five times a year at Jose Feed the Hungry, really to show and prove that people have really not forgotten about each other.
Mm-hmm.
People do care, but they need a vehicle through which to do it. And Jose Feed the Hungry can be your vehicle in 2020. It's our 50th anniversary next year. It's your time to plug in. Don't be fussing at me because you couldn't get a volunteer spot.
Mm-hmm. Get involved.
Go
get
online, number4hosea.org. Fill out your volunteer profile so you'll be in the email chain to get all the information. Each one can teach one and help one through Hosea Helps, Jose Feed the Hungry.
Yes, indeed. Before you go, Ms. O, I know you were very young when Dr. King passed away. Your dad having a lot of very close interaction with him.
Yes.
What was one of the things that he used to tell you when you got a little bit older about Dr. King and some of the things that they went through?
Well, you know, my dad, Jose, he was not nonviolent.
Mm. Yeah.
And to work with Dr. King, you had to pledge to be nonviolent.
Yeah.
I mean, Jose Williams came out. He was the original OG.
Yeah, I know, that's right.
Okay. I mean, he would definitely throw down with you at any given minute.
Yeah.
And you could tell when it was getting ready to happen because he would start crying. If you saw them tears coming in his eyes,
here comes the storm.
Back way up.
Here comes the storm.
And always was packing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So... when we left Savannah, Dr. King hired him out of Savannah, Georgia, saying that he was the man singly most responsible for integration in Savannah, and brought him here. He said he met Jesus Christ when he met Martin Luther King.
Wow.
He put his gun down. He put away his violence, and he became completely opposite individual, completely nonviolent, so that you could have hot coffee poured on you, you could be spit in the face,
have rocks thrown at you.
Mm-hmm. Listen, you could have fire hoses shot at your children. You could not fight back.
Mm.
And that, to me, is the measure of a man or a woman: self-control, dedicated to a mission, knowing that you cannot succeed. Hatred cannot destroy hatred.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Only love. I remember when we were attacked in Forsyth County, I stared into the face of a woman with a Klan outfit on, and she had a little four-year-old with her, and the four-year-old was in complete Klan outfit, pointed hat and everything, and she was standing on the side of the road, and they were throwing rocks and feces at us, urine and everything, and I somehow just looked at her face. We locked in that moment, and I said, I love you. She just freaked out. She dropped. You could see that love just melt that hate in her. So I've seen it face to face. And if I learned anything, I remember Dr. King had me on his lap when I was about maybe 12 years old. And they had these staff meetings where they would go out in the woods and fight each other. And especially my dad and Andy Young.
They would do what?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they'd go out in the woods and they'd fight. I mean, they call each other every name in the book and you this and you that.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'd get it all out. And then they'd come back and they'd change the world.
Yeah.
Because they were changed.
Powerful.
So you have to start with yourself.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Oh, man, I absolutely love it, man. Miss Elisabeth Omilami, thank you for everything you do for us, what you do for the city, what you do for the world. Hosea Helps is doing it once again. Amazing. 2020 celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King. Come on. Come on down, man. Give some money. Give some time.
Yes, we need
give a
finances.
Little love, because that's what Dr. King would want you to do. Give to this organization. Thank you so much for coming, sweetheart.
Thank you, my brother.
Yes.
We're here again.
We made it
another year.
And real quick, because I know these new millennials, they're very into the Cash App.
Yeah, you
so
can do that.
If you can't make it, you can donate online for Hosea.org or the Cash App, the money sign, Hosea Helps. Just get in where you fit in, do your part. Every little bit helps.
That's right. Thank you.
That's a lot.
All right.
Yeah.